Hello, thanks for coming back. This is our video where we are going to show you all about the customer service and telephone skills. These are the courses which you are going to apply, which you are going to subscribe for, and you may be wondering what is inside, what will you be getting at that price, and is that just for 1 month you're getting the course. That's why I am here. I am here to explain to you, or let me say, make you at ease to go ahead, subscribe for that course. That course is not going to be completed by completing all those chapters there. Customer service, telephone skills, professionals do not stop learning when they finish this type of course. Most of you people, of course, will also be working in the same profession while you are doing this course. So you are also linking your practical experience, day-to-day experience, with what we are teaching you there. So my advice, don't treat this as just a theoretical course and the practical you have to do in front of the customer. I wish we had simulators like the airlines use for their pilots, so they don't damage the plane while they are learning. Similarly, good quality service providers in Dubai and in any other place will not put a newcomer and a person who's still learning the art of human handling to go and start dealing directly with the guests. They may ruin that business. They may make those guests go away. It will become a big nuisance and a headache for a newcomer to start dealing with the guest directly. Normally, in an apprenticeship type of situation, they will put you with some senior people. The senior people will be, you will be like a caddy for them. You will be carrying their papers, you will be carrying their orders while you are learning, while you are listening and observing. That every organization cannot afford nowadays. They cannot pay those extra salaries just to teach you. Or in real apprenticeship courses, it may be you are paying them to learn that course. Those times are over now. Those apprenticeships may be still continuing, but for professions like construction, plumbing, engineering, these type of situations may require a person to really go and learn hands-on experience. In a hospitality, in a retail business where every moment of a customer's or a guest's experience is critical to the bottom line of that organization. It's critical to that tingling sound of the cash register when the money is coming in. The money comes in, it's being carried by these guests, the footfalls, the people who come and purchase from you. Just putting goods on a shelf, being in a nice location, does not guarantee that all the guests, all the customers are going to come and purchase from you. You may have the latest gadgets, you may have the latest things. It's the human interaction, it's the service, it's the people who are dealing with those customers who will get the business. I'll tell you a secret. You must be wondering, a neighbor, or maybe your competitor, maybe you have been to some place. Remember, all customer service people are also customers in some other place. You also are on the other side of the fence. So observe, see how those people handle you. So the secret was that your competitors or the shop next to you may not have the quality of the goods as you keep, as you stock, but still the competitor, the person who's next door, is still getting more business than you. The secret, as I so told you, was the human interaction, the relationship with the guest, with their customers. If you make those customers feel at home, as if it is their own place, its own hotel, as if they are family members, believe me, they will overlook many mistakes. In fact, they will be your advisors. They will tell you, please, this happened this time. Next time, please don't repeat that. That's a guarantee nobody gives nowadays that they will be back again. You are lucky if you are giving them that relationship, that they feel comfortable to come back again, irrespective of the mistake that you may have made or your employee may have made. Be, count yourself lucky that that guest is going to come back and he is kind enough to let you know what went wrong and where to improve. That feedback is the name of the game nowadays. That's why all this online, the social media, everybody has an ear to the social media. They're listening to the guest's feelings, the guest's comments, the guest's desires. You have to tune yourself to that. The guest, the customer is everything nowadays. They are just a click away. They are just a step away to the next shop. They may come to window shopping. They may stand outside your showroom, but they may not enter. Not because of the goods. Because of the number of people who are going and coming back empty-handed. They are watching all this thing. People can come into your shop. And if you are a religious person, irrespective of any religion in the world, if you are a religious person, you will be grateful. You will thank God that these people are coming to your shop. They are being sent by a higher authority. In Arabic, in this country, they call it risk, R-I-Z-K, that it is by God who is sending us these customers. So how would you take care of such people who have in your eyes become divine? They are bringing your sustenance, your money, your profit, your being out of business or flourishing and opening more branches. All depends on how you handle these people. Don't let them go out empty-handed. Don't let them be ignored. You may have a lot of people standing at the counter. There may be people waiting. You have to include each and everybody there at the counter that they have been noticed, that they are in your radar. You have watched them, you are watching them, but because there are other people in line, you cannot take care of them, you cannot serve them. So just smile at them, give them a signal that you have been noticed, I'll be with you in a minute. Don't ignore them because you are busy with one customer. That one customer may buy $10 worth of thing, and while the others who are waiting may be worth maybe $1,000 of thing. You never know. So don't think that. Always they say the bird in hand is better than two in the bush. It does not apply here. The bird in hand, the customer who's talking to you, is good. Thank God for that. But those two who are waiting behind them, they may not be in the bush. They are out in the open. So why are you wondering that they cannot be seen? They are being seen. You are seeing them. And still, if you are not doing eye-to-eye contact, letting the customer know, the guest know, that we are here to serve you and we will be with them in a moment. And another trick I'll tell you, the trick of the trade. If you have maybe 10-15 people in line, it happens, it's human. These things cannot be controlled. We cannot plan them that perfectly, that scientifically. That you have staffed out, you have scheduled everything, all people on duty. But sometime, lucky you, sometime, there are more people there than you expected. They are standing there, it's a rush. What do you do? While you are dealing with the customer who is in front of you, speak out to the other guest, excuse me, if anybody has a question or an urgent query, I can deal with them now while I'm dealing with this customer. The reason for this is that other customer may just be there to inquire about something. He may not be buying anything, so why keep him waiting? He can give him the answer and he will go away, but he will be pleased. He will be very appreciative. He will remember you. Remember, he will come back next time when they want something. For example, you are a garment shop. And this guy is asking you for a pantyhose who he wants to buy for his wife. He's asking for a particular color and you know you don't have it in stock. Wouldn't it be better to ask, listen to him and tell him, sorry, we don't have it in stock now. Could I have your phone number and we will call you the moment it comes. And the maximum time it will take, I'm expecting them within 2 days. If you can wait that long, we will call you, or if you want, I can send it to your address. How is that for customer service? What have you done here? That customer would have waited maybe seventh in the line while you are dealing with other customers, you're getting their products, and every customer is costing you about 10 to 15 minutes. Calculate this to the seventh person standing there. And when his turn comes or her turn comes, she's not buying, she's just inquiring. And then she asks for these panty, or he asks for these pantyhose, and you say, sorry, we don't have them. That person's time has been wasted. It's not your fault, it's not his fault, it's not the other customer's fault. But you could have handled it better, because this way, this customer will have a bad memory, as they say, a bad taste in the mouth. When he walks out, irrespective of it's not your fault, he will hesitate to come back to your shop. How would you like to go to a restaurant where it's very famous for its food, the taste, the cleanliness, the hygiene, but every time you have to wait 10 to 20 minutes to 30 minutes to get a table? Good food is okay, people will sacrifice for that, but every time waiting, a time will come when they will say, okay, next time when I have a guest, I'll bring you. So let me go somewhere else because it's my lunch break. I don't have that much time. You're losing people again. That's where the friendship comes in. If you had made those people feel at home as your family, they would have phoned you before coming. You could have told them, sorry, we are out of place. Or if they are regular, keep a seat for them. Reserve a table. Extra table, reserve it, and keep on giving it to those people who are your regulars. There is a rule which applies here in any business. 10% of your customers, your guests, give you 90% of your business. It always applies. I may have exaggerated, I have 10-10, but it's normally they say 20% of your customers give you 80% of your business. Seek them out, keep them in your eyes, keep them close to your chest. These are the people who will give you business. They will bring you more business. Okay, what about the 80% customers who give you only 80% or 1% of their business? They are also valuable. You have to start converting them to the category of the 20% who give you 80% of the business. It's a long, long, very vast, very deep occupation you are in. It cannot be covered by these manuals on telephone etiquette, telephone skills, customer service skills. Customer service is nothing. It's not a science, it's not a department in any place where people go and you don't care for them, you are busy, you say sorry, if you want any inquiry, you can go to the customer service desk. They are concerned with the customers, we are not concerned. This is what signal you are giving. Is that right? Is that appropriate for the business you are in? Hospitality, shopping malls, foodstuff, restaurant, they are all related to human experience. It's a business where you have to be relaxed from morning till the time you check out or you finish your duty. It's a creative job. It's not A, B, C. If a question A comes, the answer is B. That's what we give. It's not a parroting thing. It's not something which you remember by rote and give off B to C. Every situation is different. Every customer is different. Every requirement is different. You have to suit them together. You have to match them. Your mind should always be active. Believe me, it's showmanship. It's like actors, film industry, television industry. Those actors and all, even if they have a bereavement at home and they have a performance to do, they have to be at a show, an event. they will perform with their full focus on that. Afterwards, they'll do whatever is required. You have to be present all the time. Don't come to the duty when you have a tussle with your spouse, when you have an argument with your bus driver, when you have your neighbor giving you problem, your children are making nuisance in the house, your son's results are not that good. Don't bring those worries, those things to your duty. You have to be there clear-minded, because it's like a nursing profession, it's like the health caregiver profession. If the sisters and the doctors, they are worried about their own families, they will not be able to notice your problems, your patient's problems. The patient may have some critical disease which they have to immediately take a decision on. It could be left in life and death. They have to be focused full, like 99% of their attention on that job. Same is with customer service. So what? If you were not in the good mood and maybe you talked rudely to some customer, it's one customer. There are many fish in the pond, plenty of other fish, they will come. This thing always has a limit, and there will be a time when people who are out of the box and people who are out of the crowd, known for their courtesy, their diplomacy, their service, will always win. Those are the people who are branching out. They are not stagnant. They are not staying in just one place. They are not only always cutting corners. They don't make profit by cutting expenses. There is a limit to that. Otherwise, your service goes into deficiency. You start giving poor service. You don't satisfy your customers. Why do you have to keep on reducing your expenses? Why don't you look at the other side and start making your profits increase? When you increase your profits, you have more leeway. You have more things to offer to your customers. You can provide them better comfort. This, as I said, can go on and on and on. The purpose of this video is that take these courses. I'm here. I'll be continuing with you, and regularly we'll be uploading the latest videos, which you as a subscriber, because you are a monthly subscriber, it is a continuation thing. You will be informed of those videos. Even if you don't come to our website regularly, you will be intimated that new videos have been added. And if you have even bought this course as a training company or as an in-house training department, or you are a trainer in some place, even you will be getting those updates regularly. This software is not complete. It will never be complete. It will never stop. It will keep on growing. So please come back to this place, take your course, and you will be getting this certificate which will be coming up on your screen. You will be a proud owner of this certificate.
Hi guys, I'm back again with some good news. And I told you there will be a certificate we'll be issuing to everybody. You'll be seeing it at the end of the video. It will be displayed. Yaha! See, this is our achievement. Now you can fulfill the wishes of your children, your family, your loved ones by sending them money, the gifts. Because after this, you will have the job of your dreams. Your position will change and you will sleep properly at night without any worries, because you have arrived. You have found the job of your anticipation, the job which you love after doing this certificate. Thank you.